Hi there, I'm Erin, Arnold with the Communications and Engagement team at Autodesk Research. I'm here today with another 3x3 interview where I ask three questions to three people. Today I'm talking to three of our amazing interns as they wrap up their summer experience at Autodesk. I'll have each of them share a quick introduction, talk about what they're studying and where they're currently located, and then we'll dive into the questions. Saelyne, why don't you start?
Hi, everyone. My name is Saelyne. I'm a PhD student at KAIST, located in South Korea. I'm currently doing my internship at the Toronto office, and it's actually my first time in Canada, and I gotta say, I really love it here. So I'm a research intern in the Human-Computer Interaction and Visualization group, where we research about VR, AR, generative design tools, or data visualization, or software learning. It's a pretty cool team, I think.
Awesome. Gadiel, why don't you go next?
Sure. Hi, everyone. I'm Gadi. I'm a PhD candidate at Stanford. My research primarily involves using computer vision and combining that with machine learning and robotics to better help robots do kind of different tasks like exploration and path planning. My internship currently is in San Francisco in Pier 9.
Awesome. Thanks. Andrew, why don't you wrap us up with your awesome headphones there?
Will do. I'm Andrew. I'm studying mechanical engineering at Olin College as an undergraduate in Needham, Massachusetts. I'm currently interning at the Boston Technology Center as the shop intern.
Awesome. I love how you all bring such different unique experience to Autodesk and how you're all doing such different things within the research organization. I know we're certainly happy to have you guys here, and I hope your summer internships are going well. So first question, how did you first learn about this internship? We'll go ahead and start with you, Gadi.
So kind of a fun story. My advisor was actually at a conference, and he met my current manager, Nick Carey. Nick Carey basically asked my advisor if there would be any person in his lab that would be interested in potentially doing research with robotic assembly. He immediately thought of me and kind of reached out and say, hey, are you interested in this internship? And after I learned a little more about it, I was very, very like, yes, I want to please introduce me to the team. And from there, I kind of did the application process and got hired.
And what about you, Andrew?
Yeah, so I actually learned about the internship through a LinkedIn job post. I was searching in a sort of frenzied job search for the summer. And I actually saw the post and realized that I had a unique position where I had attended a career technical high school program where I majored in architecture and had heavy experience with the AutoCAD and Revit packages in specifics. So I found that it was sort of an excellent marriage between my mechanical inclinations in my college studies and my high school career with architecture studies. And so I saw fit to apply, and here I am. So it's been a fun journey.
That's great. And what about you, Saelyne?
So I'm studying human-computer interaction in my grad studies, and Autodesk Research has a great presence in our research domain. So they have been really productive, and I've been closely following their work since the beginning of my grad studies. And one day I had the chance to engage in a conversation with a researcher who happens to be my current manager, Justin. And we were discussing some conference related matters. And that was when I got to know about this internship opportunity. So I applied without any hesitance, because I've been a huge fan of Autodesk Research for quite a long time.
So we got a combination of networking and some searching on social media for internships. That's great. That's kind of how it works for most people. So second question, let's talk about some of the projects and activities you guys have worked on this summer. We'll go ahead and start with you on this one, Andrew.
I've been a part of daily machine shop operations here in the Boston Technology Center, and that entails running and maintaining the machines in the metal, wood, and 3D additive shops. So I've been learning their strengths and weaknesses, limitations, and all of that, how they functionally work. It's been great. And worked with the other Technology Center interns on the Intern Design Challenge, which we won for the execution award. So that was a lot of fun. And yeah.
Woohoo, congrats on that award. That's exciting.
Thank you.
Saelyne, you want to talk about what you've worked on?
So I'm currently focused on assisting users in learning software applications like Vision 360 or AutoCAD. So these software tools offer a great potential for impressive work, but at the same time, it can be really hard to learn how to use them. So one of the popular help resources is tutorial videos where the demonstrator records their screen, demonstrating their workflow and providing some explanations. But there's several challenges in following such tutorial videos. So basically we are exploring how we can use AI to improve the experience of watching and following software tutorial videos.
That's fascinating. I love how you're kind of marrying the work that you're doing at school along with, you know, AI, which everyone's really, really into AI right now. Gadi, what about you?
So for this summer, I worked on using an in-house robotic simulator that has the ability to create a digital twin of a real-world robotic assembly workspace. And using this tool, I basically trained fully connected neural networks called neural radiance fields for the purpose of simulated and real-world assembly components. Our goal was to use this information to help robots do kind of visual surveying and like state estimation of where the robot is during the assembly process. The kind of concept was that at each time step, the robot would take an image of the real world, of the real like workspace, and then render an image in the NeRFs and compare the two and say, okay, is there any differences between them? Has an error occurred? And if so, can I fix this? Can I resolve this issue? Or do I need to kick this problem up to a human who knows better than what I do? And it was a really cool process working on this and like doing these type of stuff.
Yeah, no, it sounds fascinating. The projects that you guys are working on are amazing. And I know one of the things that Autodesk really prides itself on with working with interns is providing opportunities to do real world research, work on these projects that, you know, after you guys are gone, we're going to keep working on them. So, you know, thank you again for all the great work that you guys are kicking off for us. Finally, what would you say is the most interesting or surprising thing from your internship at Autodesk? We'll start with Saelyne this time.
So I really love the people here. They are really supportive and they are very proactive in giving feedback and have a good collaboration culture. So whenever I face any problems, there's always someone whom I can discuss the matter with. And I truly feel that my project gets lots of attention and I'm learning a lot from the people around me.
Gadi, what about you?
I have to also agree that I really love the people here. It's really great working with them. But besides that, two things really come to my mind. One is that I got to work with actual robotic arms, which is fun to program and like watch what they do. It's almost mesmerizing kind of how they move. And then the other thing was that towards the middle of my internship, we had an internal hackathon where we like the entire team worked on this one specific task and just did whatever they needed to get it to work. And just that experience was really great. And being able to like interact with everyone in the team and on this common goal was amazing.
Yeah, fantastic. Andrew, why don't you close us out?
Yeah, I'm going to echo the appreciation for the community here at Autodesk. The people that I've been working with have provided me lots of opportunities to learn from them and how they work, how they think, and you know how they behave with their relationship to Autodesk and their work. And that's been invaluable in terms of gaining friendships, gaining connections, and gaining skills. So Autodesk has been a great place to hone that sort of skill expression and explore where I can be helpful in that environment.
Thank you so much for your time. Thank you for sharing this great information and for all the work you've done this summer. Wish you well as you guys head back to school over the next few weeks, and I hope you guys have gained as much from Autodesk as we have from you. Thanks again for your participation in this.
Thank you. Nice.